So with the insanity of chapter 167, we were left with an unwavering Garou claiming that he will copy Saitama's limitless power limitlessly until he wins. Since becoming Cosmic Fear Garou, there is absolutely no ability or technique that he can't copy and use immediately. And this popped a light bulb in my head and got me thinking of some abilities that he could still use or could have copied to be an even more threatening force, believe it or not. So in today's video, I'll be discussing three specific abilities that we've seen in the series that I think would make Garou completely busted if he copied them. And if he copied all three of these, Saitama would be in for a long, long fight. This is Anime Anxiety, the channel where we talk all things anime and manga. So let's get right into it. So we know that once Garou was given abilities by God, he gained the knowledge of the flow of all energy and the behavior of all forces in the universe. So we can assume that if he understood it on like a molecular level, he'd be able to copy it. And that brings me to the first ability that would make Garou totally busted, and that's if he copied Black S's abilities. Now, I know that he's previously fought and defeated Platinum S, so it wouldn't make too much sense that he'd get that much more powerful if he defeated a lesser version of Platinum S, which was Black S. But I think that the ability that Black S had before he did his merger into Golden S and Platinum S would be very interesting for Garou to copy. Imagine if Garou was able to make trillions of versions of himself, all with Cosmic Fear Garou powers. Like, just imagine 1,000 Garous all opening hyperspace gates at the same time and just bouncing back and forth between them, hitting Saitama again and again and again. So if Saitama was even able to defeat one of them, he'd still have thousands or hundreds of thousands more to deal with. And on top of that, just imagine like 1,000 nuclear fission punches at one time, or even a ton of gamma ray bursts at the same time. Like, I mean, you guys get the point. Like, the possibilities are endless with this, because all of the amazing abilities and feats that Garou has at this point will be multiplied by potentially trillions. And who knows, maybe if he copied Black S's abilities, there'd be a version where he can merge all of his hundreds of thousands or millions of copies into an even stronger Cosmic Fear Garou. Now that would be insane. Now, the second ability that I wanted to talk about here is actually Zombie Man's insane regeneration. We see that Zombie Man can have his head blown off, can get his heart completely destroyed, and just be blown apart into pieces without dying. To this point, we've seen no limit to the regenerative powers of Zombie Man, so at this point we can just call it limitless regeneration. Now, Garou's body seems to be invulnerable at this point because he's taken several serious attacks from Saitama and is still standing and wanting more, so it would be kind of redundant to have him have a regenerative power if he doesn't take that much damage in the first place. But we know that Saitama's eventually going to wear down Garou and defeat him, so having this regenerative ability, Garou can just recklessly throw himself at Saitama without having to worry about taking any fatal damage. And on top of that, we see that Zombie Man has the benefit of endurance because of this ability. He can outlast his opponents. Right now, Garou is not matching up to the power of Saitama, so maybe it can be this tortoise and the hare scenario where he just outlasts him, you know, because Saitama might have limitless endurance, but it really hasn't been tested yet to this point. So now combining this with the previous Black S abilities, just imagine hundreds of thousands, if not millions, of Cosmic Fear Garous fighting Saitama for days and days on end, and when one of them gets their head blown off or their arm blown off or like a hole in their chest, they just regenerate and keep coming at him. Now you guys see what I mean by completely busted, right? Combining all of these is insane. So Garou won't just be invulnerable, he'll literally be immortal basically. Now, the third ability is actually kind of a failsafe if the other two aren't enough, and this would be Phoenix Man's ability to reincarnate himself after he's died. Now, we know that Saitama isn't looking to kill Garou because he promised Terrio that he'd bring him back alive, but imagine if Garou is pushing Saitama to the point where he can't finish him off because there's so many copies of him and each one of those copies keeps regenerating. And if he somehow is able to kill off all of them by completely obliterating their bodies, then they could just be reborn again, or Garou himself could just be reborn again and come back stronger. So Saitama wouldn't be looking to directly kill Garou, but he's obviously trying to wipe out his copy, so having them be extremely hard to kill by regenerating instantly, and once he does kill them, having them be reborn in a stronger form, I mean, it'd be hard to see where Saitama comes out winning in this one. Not for lack of power, but just by getting completely worn out, because who knows, maybe he still needs to breathe in space, you know? Maybe he's been holding his breath this whole time and he needs to finish this fight quick. So having all these three combined abilities would make it a super, super hard time for Saitama to finish things quickly. So in summary, if Garou was able to make millions and trillions of copies of himself with Black S's ability, be able to regenerate and have his copies regenerate as quickly as Zombie Man could, and even if all of this fails and is defeated or most of his copies are killed, have them be reborn again by using Phoenix Man's ability, it would just make this a totally busted fight. It would literally last like 100 chapters, right? I don't know, I thought this was a very interesting topic to explore, and I want to hear what you guys think. Let me know what other abilities Garou would be able to copy to make him completely busted, like he would be with these three. Did I miss some good ones, or do you guys not agree with the ones I laid out? Let me know in the comments, let's have a conversation here. But if you enjoyed the video, please drop a like, and please subscribe. I drop One Punch Man content multiple times a week, so you won't have any shortage of it here. But until next time, I'll see you guys later.